Four Beats by Alex J.
First and 10. We in the trenches. You like the water cooler. You be on the benches.
Hey, week 10. KTZ Broadcasting. Witherspoon Insurance pregame show. Terry Reinhart, Sam Davis joining you here for as we come down the home stretch. Terry?
What week did you say? 10.
Week 10, yeah. What happened to week 3 when we were looking at everything out before of us, but in front of us, and here we are now. Things are laid out. We got a really good idea as to who's who and who isn't.
We do, all except the Southern District 7. I think it can still change with that middle pack.
Well, exactly. And still a long shot at the top. The top changes, but it'll take a big upset for the top of the conference to change.
I got a feeling that top will never change in the Southern District 7.
Well, not this year, probably. But, hey, if you want to give us a call, we'd love to hear from you. 704-482-1390. In Gaston County, 704-435-3297. In Lincoln County, 704-735-8071. Give us a call. We'd love to hear what you have to say about it. Some pretty good games tonight. No blockbusters like we've had in the past, but some good quality football games.
Yeah, if you're going to a game tonight, give us a holler. We'd like to hear what you really have to say because we're coming down the stretch. Has your team done good? Have they done bad? Either way, could your team have done something different this year? I mean, you know, I know how it is out there. You're like me, Sam. When you go to a football game, whether it's high school, college, pro, or whatever, you're a coach.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, hey,
everybody.
I would have loved to have seen this happen.
And that can be frustrating sometimes when you're in the stands listening to some idiot scream, throw the ball, when it's like, you know, third and a half a yard.
Yes, you know. Exactly.
But, yeah, everyone's an armchair coach. But tonight's games on the KTC Broadcasting lineup, our Gaston County Game of the Week, Hunter Huss travels over to Kramer High School. Derek Smith and Brent Pasco will bring you all that action. And Lincoln County Game of the Week, Lincolnton at Newton Conover, announcers David Keever and Rick Mitchum. And that's probably, if I had to pick one, that'd be our game of the week right there.
It is a battle for second.
Battle for second place in the SD7. Shelby is off tonight, and they will not be playing. They'll be laid up in the chair watching Oprah reruns, I guess. Burns travels over to the Drawn. Calvin Hastings and Dan Greer will bring you all that action. And East Rutherford is over at Crest. Andy Foster, Tim Foster, and Rob Roop with that.
And on the radio on WCSL 1590. Pine Lake at Cherryville, WOHS 1390 AM, East Rutherford at Crest, and WLON 1050 AM. That's that game, Lincoln at Newton Conover.
And don't forget the Rinaldo Auto Mall postgame show tonight. Later on, immediately following the first game ending, Dennis Davis, Tom Centofanti, Terry Reinhart brings you the scores, recaps, interviews, and phone calls. And speaking of phone calls, Terry, we've got one right now. Steve, who's on the line?
All righty.
It is I.
Lewis.
How are you, Lewis?
Where you been, brother?
Well, I've been around here and there, going up to Newton Conover tonight.
Oh, you making the trip to Newton? I figured
my son is in, and he's going to take me up there. Normally, I wouldn't go to a away game like that because too much driving at night, but he's here, so we're going to the football game.
Understand that. Is that Matt that's in?
Yeah, Matt.
All righty. What kind of game do you expect to see up that way?
I expect to see a good ball game. And Coach Klinger seems to think that if they can win that one tonight, they can finish second and maybe get a couple home playoff games.
Oh.
That's absolutely.
They're looking at it as a big one.
And that's a prize worth playing for right there, a couple home playoff games.
Yes.
Big for the budget, exactly. Big for the crowd.
Do what?
It's big for the athletic budget to get that home gate, and it's also for your local fans.
Yes, sir.
Well, on the local front, Lewis, Bessemer City's making that trip up to Thomas Jefferson. What do you think odds are?
But I noticed today the records are the same, 6-2 and 2-0, but I feel like Bessemer, last couple times I've watched Bessemer, I tell you, they don't look bad.
Well, you know, when we come into the year, everybody knew all about Cedric Mackey. But, the quarterback, Tyler Bess, he's taken a real step up and leading this
team.
Listen,
he's put on a show. They run that triple option. And because you have to respect Mackey, you know, the first option, then that's opened it up for Bess. Because a lot of people keying on Mackey, and Bess has been keeping the ball and running that thing. And then they've got a, I forget who the triple option guy is, but they run some of that too. And I tell you, last couple times I watched them, they looked pretty good.
Well, you know, last year's game, Bessemer City won it 40-21. And
yes.
You know, now you make a trip up to somewhere. I guess this is Bessemer City's probably first time going to Thomas Jefferson.
I think so, yes. And that'll be good. I don't know how much of a crowd they'll carry up there. I doubt very many, because that's up in Burke County, isn't it?
It is. And I know a lot of
times. Whoa, wait. What are you talking about? Thomas Jefferson's in Rutherford County. Yeah, they're Rutherford just across County. The Cleveland County yes. line.
Oh, it's in Rutherford County. Yes.
Yeah, they're over yes. close to, not far from Boiling Springs.
Not far from who?
Boiling Springs, North Cleveland County.
Oh,
yeah, they're
I didn't
just,
know that.
They're not.
Okay.
They're pretty close. If you were going from Shelby to Chase High School, you'd almost go right by Thomas Jefferson.
Oh, okay. I got you.
It's not too far away.
I know where they are then. Well, I tell you, that'd be good for Bessemer if they can win that thing. Of course, then they're going to have to beat Cherville in the last game of the year.
Well, you know, that surprised us last year, Lewis, that loss to Cherville. But I honestly do not feel like that's going to be an issue this year.
Well, probably not. I think maybe you're right, too, because, and even last year with a home game, Cherville is down compared to what they have been, and I don't think it's going to be much of an issue either. I believe Bessemer will win it going away, but you never know.
You don't. That's why they play them.
That's exactly why they play them. Well, guys, listen, I'm going to let you go here, and y'all get on and talk some more football. We like to listen to you on Friday night and see what's going on. So,
thank you, Lewis.
You keep us informed.
We'll do the best we can.
Talk to you later, bud.
All right.
Thank you. Lewis Carpenter, former
Bye-bye. Former
host of the Rinaldo Auto Mall postgame show, and I guess he'll make a cameo from time to time
on the
show when he can get up here and find a ride, because I know how hard it is to drive at night. Sometimes
it
gets harder and harder the older I get. I don't know. It just you have to go slower. That's why when I'm 20, fussing at the old people ahead of me driving so slow, now I understand why they were driving so slow. But thanks, Lewis, for the call there. I want to just, we've covered over that. Where's my little sheet here? I wanted to just mention quickly last week's highlights. There were some really great games. The Forest View win over South Point.
Yes.
But two players that really stood out last week, Jeff Glenn, the quarterback at Ashbrook, and Chaz Surratt, the quarterback at East Lincoln, both had accounted for over 500 yards of offense each and 5-plus touchdowns in one game. Talk about Superman efforts, and both of them won games. Both of them won important games.
Yes, they did. And, you know, East Lincoln, Chaz Surratt will be back on the field tonight as they host, they travel up to West Caldwell. And then Ashbrook in a big game for them against Forest View, for over at Forest View for that conference lead. Could end up being a three-way tie if Ashbrook can pull off an upset in the Big South 2A, 3A if South Point comes through with a win over Lake Norman Charter. But, you know, in the conferences, you're coming down the stretch. A lot of people, when you look at the Southern District 7, everybody thinks East Lincoln's got that one pretty much wrapped up. The battle is for second and third and fourth.
Oh, absolutely.
Down that way, you know. And when you look at the Southern Piedmont, everything's still up for grab. You got a good game night, Bessemer City, Thomas Jefferson. Cherville, Pine Lake Prep, still hanging in there, one of them.
They are both in a position to win the conference. Not likely, but they are there when they need to be.
Exactly.
And now it's up to the kids to make the plays, the coaches to call the right plays. And if you perform, you have a chance to win and be in position to play for a championship in a few weeks.
And you're speaking of quarterback Jeff Glenn from Ashbrook as they make that trip to Forest View. Huge game for them. Everybody talked about them being the top team in the Big South at the start of the year. Well, all of a sudden, here's your game. If you want to be the top, you go over to Forest View and you beat them and lock it all up.
Well, Ashbrook really, really struggled early. They were just pitiful, trying to figure out what they were going to do, moving quarterback Austin Mitchell to wide receiver and back to quarterback and back to wide receiver. Then he got hurt. And now it looks like they've found something with Jeff Glenn. I think they're running him at the quarterback now, I believe. And they are actually beginning to show some life offensively. They gave South Point a good game, had an opportunity to win that. They've won three of their last four games. So this game tonight is big for both Forest View and Ashbrook. both have qualified. Let me look at Ashbrook is 4-4.
3-1.
And both teams have actually qualified for the playoffs. But in this case, they're vying for a conference title. And Ashbrook does have the talent to win this game. Based on earlier performances, Terry, it's not likely they'll win, but they can.
Well, it's one of them games, and Ashbrook, I've kind of wondered about them all the year. They kind of fell off at the start of the year. And then a couple weeks ago, they played North Gaston, and North Gaston led mostly all the game until the very end, and Ashbrook pulled it out at the end. And I thought about them again. I'm like, man, you know, what is wrong with this team that we expected to be at the top? Well, you know, here they are tonight, 4-4, 3-1, battling at Forest View, 6-2, 4-0. Hey, this is your chance. I mean, this is what it's all about. Step up tonight. Everybody will forget what you've done in the past.
Oh, absolutely.
You know,
all those non-conference ugly games they had where they were MIA, DOA, AWOL, everything.
Exactly.
They were terrible, but now they're right where you have to be to have a shot at winning a conference title. Well, let's go into the Southern District 7 real quick and cover over some of those games tonight. If I can find my list of games. There it is. Maiden is going to travel over to West Lincoln. Terry, this is a middle-of-the-pack game. Maiden comes in 1-3 in the conference, West Lincoln 2-2. This is that middle-of-the-pack game where these guys have got to make a statement. Maiden currently they've got 4 wins, as does West Lincoln. So they're actually, at this point, they're definitely playing for their playoff life. They really, really need that 5th win. But they're also that seeding process. Where do you finish in your conference?
Well, it's a game that you come into, Maiden on the road, and people say, okay, what can happen here? Well, if Maiden wins, they go to 5-4, 2-3. That will drop West Lincoln behind them on account of the head-to-head victory.
Right.
West Lincoln has not defeated Maiden since 1985. It's been 29 years. It's almost like Kansas City making the World Series. It has been forever.
Well, for many, many years, Maiden has been a juggernaut. They've been one of those teams at the top of the list year after year after year. And I think you would honestly say that until last year, West Lincoln has struggled for many, many years.
It is.
And who knows why, but they have. They've shown some life last year, had a really good run last year. They're a middle-of-the-pack 500-type team this year. They have a chance to really do some damage as they played a couple teams in their conference close this year.
They have, and Maiden comes into this game. Maiden is trying to extend a streak of 18 straight not losing seasons that they have never had. If you lose tonight, you fall to 4-5. You go to 1-4, and, you know, I mean, you're going to have a couple games left. Can you finish above? Or the 1-4 is going to put you at the very lower of the part of this conference, and chance on making the playoffs is going to be very slim. You know, yeah, you could pick up win 5 next week, but, you know, to me, this conference, and when you all have a two-way conference and every team is in it, all 8 of them, you know, they're not only going to go so far deep. They're not every team in this conference going to make the playoff. And I got a feeling like 5 out of the 8 are going to get in. I think they'll go 5 deep. But number 6, you're going to be really on a borderline down there to make the playoffs.
Well, that would be West Lincoln, Maiden, and West Caldwell. West Caldwell on the bubble right now, 3-5, and the other two fighting it out for that 5th spot in the conference, which, as you said, could be the magic number.
West Lincoln, though, is looking for this game. They've been saying this could be their year. You got a team that's averaging 321 yards rushing a game against everybody that they have played. That is great. Mac George leads the way with 1,532 yards. He's 260 away from the West Lincoln record. He's only 540 away from the Lincoln County record, which is held by D. Littlejohn in 2011. So, you know, a big game for them tonight on the hill. Tom Sain's he's only played Maiden one time. He lost to him last year 17-3 over at Maiden. But West Lincoln has lost 16 straight to this team. The last coach to beat West Lincoln?
Moses?
Wes Beam.
Oh, Wes Beam, really?
1985.
Wow. Going back to the good old days. And don't forget that Maiden is on a 3-game losing streak, lost to West Caldwell in that stretch. So they are prime for the picking this year. This could be West Lincoln's time. I do feel like that West Lincoln will pound the ball down the Blue Devil's throat and extend the Maiden losing streak to 4 games tonight. Hey, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll come back and finish up with the SD7 and the rest of the conferences here on the Witherspoon Insurance pregame show.
that me, I got the option. I'm the keep that or pitch that. Defense, they gotta fix that. Four receivers, we spread them out in the shotgun.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986. The financing is better than ever at Westin Sales and Vail. Right now, get 0% financing for up to 54 months on all Bobcat and Grasshopper mowers. Get 0% financing for 48 months on all Vermeer, Round Balers, and Disc mowers. Get 3.99% financing for 54 months on the Big Tex trailers. And buy a Coyote, CK, or DK Series tractor and get a free loader. Come on in now for all the details at Westin Sales, Highway 18 North in Vail, or online at westinsales.com.
45 years. Yes, 45 years. That's how long Francis Brothers Used Cars has been serving the people of Cleveland and Rutherford counties with a good selection of buy here, pay here cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. Don and Bino invite you in to check out their inventory and look forward to helping you find your next vehicle. Francis Brothers also has a service center offering oil changes, OBD inspections, brake work, shocks, axles, and CV joints. Francis Brothers Used Cars and Service Center at 134 North Main Street, downtown Boiling Springs.
Here's what's up in Cleveland, Gaston, and Lincoln counties, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WHS, WCSL, and WLON. The Lincoln and Marching Wolves are once again selling Riverside fruit from Florida until November 7th. Navel oranges, juice oranges, tangelos, and red grapefruits are available. Pickup date is December 5th from 3 to 6 p.m. If you'd like to place an order, give them a call at 828-320-3364. And the Royal Quartet will be performing at the Kaiser United Methodist Church Sunday, November 9th at 3 p.m. Enjoy Southern Gospel, Testimony, and much more. And that's What's Up, brought to you by the What's Up Shopper and Big O Country, WHS, 1390 AM, WCSL, 1590 AM, and WLON, 1050 AM. For more information, go to whatsupshopper.com or to ktcbroadcasting.com.
Time revelry at the Renaissance Festival. Weekends now through November 23rd. Great family fun, adventure, and wackiness.
That festival is so awesome.
Huzzah!
Jousting night.
Men in tights.
Oh, hi.
The Renaissance Festival is back.
We love the Renaissance Festival.
Carolina Renaissance Festival is a medieval amusement park.
Shopping! Food!
10 stages of music, comedy, daredevil antics. Weekends now through November 23rd. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter stores or print yours online at renfestinfo.com. Time traveling fun, presented by Pepsi.
I'm the Reverend Mother Redempta.
I'm Sister Philomena Claire.
And you will love the Renaissance Festival.
I do.
Now, for a limited time, get 0% financing for up to 60 months or get up to a $3,000 trade-in allowance for your old unit from Train and Roland Black Heating and Air Conditioning in Gastonia, your Train comfort specialist. Call Roland Black Heating and Air today, 704-865-1375 for all the details, or go to train.com. Again, 0% financing up to 60 months or get up to a $3,000 trade-in allowance for your old unit. Roland Black Heating and Air Conditioning, 501 East Franklin Boulevard in Gastonia. Pick up this week's What's Up Shopper for a 10% off any service or repair coupon from the Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. Offer good for up to $100 in parts and labor. But hurry, offer expires October 31st. Again, clip out the coupon in this week's What's Up Shopper for 10% off any parts or service up to $100. So hurry in now to the new Renato Auto Mall, Highway 74 bypass east of Shelby, just below the Cleveland Mall in Shelby. Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986.
Pass strap tight. My jersey shining in them Friday night lights. Win, win. We just came to win.
And the Friday night lights, a win. All right, I want to say a quick hi to a friend of mine I ran into this week, a big fan of the show, David from Hendricks Appliance. Say hi to David. He said he listens every week, and I hope David's having a good night. Hopefully he's Shelby's off tonight. I know he's a Shelby fan, but he pulls for all the local high schools. And speaking of all the local high schools, Dutch Fork Fox's hat.
Sure is, Tommy.
Did you buy
Knox.
That online? Or?
No, it was sent to me from South Carolina.
Wow. How are they doing this year? Won state last year, right,
they
down
did.
In South Carolina?
They did. The Big 16. They won everything. Well, the big time down in South Carolina.
Well,
they won
Tommy it. Knox, you have to say, he has won at every stop that he's been at. And not like, well, we talk about Matt Beam's been successful wherever he's been, but Tommy Knox has been uber successful winning state titles at every stop.
He is, and he owns the all-time record for North Carolina, 109 straight at Independence. You know, but you look at Independence nowadays, and they seem to be getting back to what they used to be. You know, and Tommy Knox is not there. So.
Well, and it's been a while since they've been back at the top of the list. But there's a lot of competition in Charlotte, Mallard Creek, Butler, and the whole run. And they rotate every couple of years. One will fall down. Butler seems to stay up there, but there's always somebody jumping up there. But that's 4A football, and that's way over in Charlotte, and we don't pay a whole lot of attention to that. Another quick hello to the Dallas Cowboy fans. I hope you guys are enjoying this year. Because you have paid your dues. You have sucked eternally for about the last, what, 5, 6, 7 years, would you say, Terry?
We have not liked that for the last 5 or 6 years.
Failures.
Well, we have not been failures.
Failures. Haven't won a playoff game in like 6 games.
Yeah.
And ain't won a playoff game during any of them. Not one playoff game.
I can name you a million teams, which ain't that many in there, but a ton of teams that's in the NFL that would love to have on last game have a chance to make the playoffs.
You sound like North Gaston about 10 years ago when that guy that went down to South Carolina would play a bunch of 1A and prep schools and build up a 6-0 preseason record and go lose his next 5 in the conference. People would kill for that 6-0 record to start the season. It don't mean nothing if you don't win at the end, and they haven't done it. But maybe this year's different.
When they had Blue, they went all the way to the state championship game.
Oh, yeah.
Against Western Alamance.
Well, that was the quirk of their existence. But I just wanted to say to the Dallas Cowboy fans, congratulations on a great year. And let's get back into the Southern District 7. If I could find my sheet of paper, Terry, what'd I do with it?
So over here, I'm going to touch on Bandy's going to Bunker Hill. Kind of a
there
defense for Bandy's to put out there. I don't know. Bunker Hill's a team that can score.
And
Bandy's is going to play defense here.
Bandy's got a 5-3 record. They're another middle-of-the-pack type team. Yeah. They've qualified for the playoffs.
They win this game. They're
this could be another one of those 40-something. But I have to say, Bunker Hill, although putting up massive offensive numbers early in the year, the last couple of weeks they've really struggled on
the offensive side. And I'm starting to wonder, remember when we started at the start of the year, you've got a lot of guys on this Bunker Hill team that are going both ways.
Right.
And as you get on into the year, especially towards the end, it is hard because these guys are wore out.
Yeah.
And then you got to come right back out every Monday, go back to practice, going over everything you got to do for the next opponents, you know, and this is a hard thing to do. Last time Bunker Hill was winless was way back in 2007, and the way teams have been scoring against them, I mean, the least amount of points that they have, how would I put
45,
that?
45,
47?
49.
Is the lowest that they have gave up. You know, Bandy's put 49 on them tonight?
No.
I don't think so.
Probably not.
That's what I'm saying.
But
I don't
Bandy
think
should
so.
Win probably more of a 30 to 20-something type game, I would think.
Yeah.
And
maybe 40.
Maybe 40 to 20-something. Yeah. But, another one of those Southern District 7 entertaining football games. High scoring, a lot of shootouts. The whole conference has just been phenomenal this year. We talked briefly to Lewis about the Lincolnton traveling over to Newton Conover. Newton Conover, after their loss to East Lincoln, are now number 10 in the state.
Yeah, they are.
Now, there's 80 to 100 2A teams in the state of North Carolina, and for the AP experts to say you're the 10th best team in the state, still pretty fantastic for Newton Conover.
Well, Coach Beam, here's his deal coming into tonight. He's playing a Lincolnton team that has the number one defense in the conference. They only give up 240 yards per game. He's going to air it out because I don't think he's going to be able to run. Now, you know, he might have this all in his little package. Like, I'm going to try to run the ball, but I think Lincoln is going to stop him there. He's going to have to put it up. Stanley, great quarterback. He can air it out. But defensive-wise, I think Lincoln is going to be able to stop him. I'm looking for a game here, and me and Kevin was talking about a minute ago. This is going to be one of them game. Either it's 40-30 or 50-40. I don't think neither team's going to be able to stop each other. But, you know, I think that Lincoln will come out on top. But now this is a close series now, because if you look at the all-time, Newton Conover leads this series 23-21-3.
I kind of disagree a little bit. I've got a little more faith in Matt Beam, I think. Lincolnton won last year, but you've got the top defense in the Southern District 7 against the number 3 offense in Newton Conover. It's smash-mouth football, which is Lincolnton. That's all they do is line up and just pound the ball. But with Roseboro and the other running backs, they're going to smash mouth you, and then Newton Conover is going to go to the spread them and shred them. They're just going to be all over the field throwing the ball, running it from time to time, trying to change it up. Another high-scoring, fun-to-watch shootout. In my opinion, flip a coin for the winner. I mean, I would not bet on either team. But you truly feel like Lincolnton's going to win this.
I got Lincolnton by 10.
They'll pound them.
At least.
And with Newton Conover's lack of defense throughout the year, you would expect Lincolnton to control the clock, limit Newton Conover's possessions. But this is that kind of game that at any time a turnover at the wrong time could lead to a change of –
Well, I want to tell you the stuff that I have seen. Here is Steve Zander. Here's something, Dagum. When I look at it, I always think I've seen a ton of people try to tackle Roseboro. And Roseboro, I've seen him against East Gaston, West Lincoln, different people. And it takes more than three or four guys to hit him.
No, one can tackle him. You just got to hang on for about 6 yards.
That's exactly right. Everybody has to grab on and hold on before this big guy comes down.
Well, he perfectly fits the description of man amongst boys. When you look at him standing on the football field, he's way thicker. He's just big. He looks like an Amazon out there amongst normal people. He's just a big guy, and that's why he's so highly recruited. Michigan wanted him, but now NC State's got him.
Another thing that's huge about this game, very important, if Lincolnton wins, that is win number 600 for the Lincolnton Wolves.
And that will be one of our KTC broadcasting games here tonight. And last game in the Southern District 7, East Lincoln, number 2 in the state of North Carolina, travels over to West Caldwell to take on the surprising West Caldwell team, who's 3-5 on the bubble for the playoffs, but they do own a upset overtime win over Maiden and almost got by West Lincoln, losing only 28-24.
You've got East Lincoln's offense that averages 42 points a game. And here we go again, Sam. Can West Caldwell's defense stop East Lincoln?
No.
I don't think there's anybody in the Southern District 7 that can do that. West Caldwell's last playoff appearance was all the way back in 2004. You know, you kind of get on them on account of it's been a while since they've been to the playoffs. Coach Chip English has turned this program tremendously all the way around. Last year, a lot of games they were getting blown out.
Terrible.
Yeah. This year, they're 3-5, 1-3. It's a tough game here because I do not think that they can win this game or even come close.
Well, and I agree with you. East Lincoln has beaten the top two teams in the conference, of Newton Conover and Lincolnton. Let me just say the top two. Two of the top three, themselves included. And now they're taking on a West Caldwell team that's much improved. Has to be proud of the effort they've got this year, proud of the progress they've made, but understand that tonight, go take your beating, move on to next week.
It is. And you think of East Lincoln, you say, okay, they played Newton Conover. Okay, 49-28. They played Lincoln like 49-27.
Right.
I mean, that's three touchdowns up. I mean, you know, on your next two best teams in the conference.
Right.
You know, so West Caldwell, you know, played a game.
they earn that number two in the state ranking and could be number one this year. And I truly, truly thought last year they were going to win state. But they got knocked out in, what, fourth round? This year, I really think the pieces are there to go on.
West Caldwell leads this all-time series 6-5.
Which is amazing when you stop and think about that.
It is.
Amazing. But that series will be tied up after this year 6-6.
Yes.
Hey, I want to take a brief moment and say thank you to the Parkway House Family Restaurant right here in Cherville. They provide us our pregame meal. Tonight, I'm doing the cheeseburger with lettuce, tomato, and mayonnaise, and onion rings. Wanted to do something different. Terry, what do you have?
Grilled ham and cheese and fries.
Ham and cheese and fries.
It is fantastic.
Well, you can reach them at 704-769-8055 here in Cherryville. A lot of times, call your order in. They've got a great to-go menu. Place your order. Pick it up on the way to the game. They're open Monday through Friday, 6 a.m. Doesn't say what time they close. I guess they close when people get tired of eating.
That's it.
But they open 7 days a week. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, a great to-go menu, and just gobs and gobs of different kinds of food. Real good food from the Parkway House Family Restaurant right here in Cherville.
And, you know, again, if anybody goes there, get you a menu. There are so much stuff on this menu.
Yeah, you got to take the menu home because it's so much stuff.
It's going to take you 2 days to read it.
All right, that's going to cover up the SD7. We'll get back and get into the South Mountain Atlantic Conference and the rest of them right after this break. Stick around.
We must protect this house.
Join Sam Davis and Terry Reinhardt for the Witherspoon Insurance Agency pregame show each and every Friday night starting at 5:30 right here on Big O Country. Plus, watch live at ktcbroadcasting.com.
I said hello.
Festival. Weekends now through November 23rd. Great family fun, adventure, and wackiness.
That festival is so awesome.
Huzzah!
Jousting night.
Men in tights.
Oh, hi.
The Renaissance Festival is back.
We love the Renaissance Festival.
The Carolina Renaissance Festival is a medieval amusement park.
Shopping!
Ten stages of music, comedy, daredevil antics. Weekends now through November 23rd. Discount tickets at Harris Teeter stores or print yours online at RenFestInfo.com. Time traveling fun, presented by Pepsi.
I'm the Reverend Mother Redempta.
I'm Sister Philomena Claire.
And you will love the Renaissance Festival.
I do.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents, Witherspoon Insurance Agency. Your independent insurance agency since 1986. I'm Calvin Hastings, and I want to invite you to the Customer Appreciation Sale this Saturday, October 25th at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. We'll be there from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. with our live Big O Country radio broadcast. Come on in and save thousands of dollars. You can get a brand new 2015 Honda Fit for only $149 per month, or a brand new 2015 Kia Forte for only $139 per month. Come on in for all the details and be sure to register to win some great prizes, including Renaissance Festival tickets, Southern Christmas Show tickets, food certificates to Smoke on the Square and Newt's, plus WhatsApp Shopper t-shirts, and win two free nights at Suncrest Cabins in Hendersonville. Plus, we'll have free Dairy Queen hot dogs, chips, and soft drinks. So plan now to be there this Saturday, October 25th, 10 a.m. till 2 p.m., all during the Customer Appreciation Sale. This Saturday at Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Old Man Winter is just around the corner. Are you ready? It's time to get ready with a stop at Future Energy Company in Shelby. Take a look at the line of Manesson vent-free gas logs, bringing you warmth, ambience, and convenience to your home. Plus, take a look at the Yodel and Lopi wood stoves. And remember, Future Energy Company does chimney cleaning, and they install and service gas logs. Future Energy Company, 130 West Graham Street in Uptown Shelby, open 10 to 5:30 Monday through Friday, 9:30 to 1 on Saturday, online at futureenergyco.com. On a cool night, there's nothing better than fresh oyster stew. And right now, at the Aura Supermarket in Broad River Ham in Shelby, you'll find fresh bucket-dipped oysters. Or get them in a shell. Just think, fresh oysters too for dinner tonight. And don't forget, Halloween is October 31st, and the Aura Supermarket at Broad River Hams has plenty of pumpkins in all sizes, plus some great meat bundles too. Aura Supermarket at Broad River Hams, 1026 East Marion Street in Shelby, welcoming Harris Teeter and Lowe's food customers. Basic Finance in Shelby has a Halloween treat for you. Need cash for Halloween or just about anything? Basic Finance in Shelby can help. Don't be afraid to come by. Just stop on in anytime. There's no trick. Just honest, hardworking people helping you get the money that you need. That's Basic Finance, 203 West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Call 704-481-0111. Remember, golf on Saturday, church on Sunday. When it comes time to cut the grass, you'll be more than happy to do it on your new Husqvarna Zero Turn Mower or Tractor Mower from Carolina Hardware and Garden Center in Lincoln. You'll find one that's right for your lawn and your pocketbook, and get free delivery of your new mower. And now is the time to service your old mower. Bring it on in or call for pickup and delivery. From parts to service to a brand new Husqvarna mower, they do it all at Carolina Hardware and Garden Center on the Reeseville Road in Lincoln, your Husqvarna dealer in this area.
This fall, we need to remember our local economy relies on public education.
Our kids are back in school, and it's impossible to miss the effects of Speaker Tom Tillis's $500 million in cuts to our local schools. Just look at our classrooms.
As a result of Tillis's education cuts, the Greensboro News and Record reported North Carolina is ranked the worst state for teachers.
And teachers are leaving the state because classrooms are overcrowded and textbooks are scarce.
Tillis even opposes a plan to make college loans more affordable.
That's not helping our families or our local economy.
But Kay Hagan knows education and the economy go hand in hand, delivering results for our teachers, increasing access to college loans, job training, and community colleges.
This November, there's a better choice.
Kay Hagan, a proven fighter for our kids and schools North Carolina can be proud of.
I'm Kay Hagan, candidate for U.S. Senate, and I approve this message.
Paid for by the Democratic Senatorial Campaign Committee and Hagan for U.S. Senate, Inc.
On November 4th, vote John Bridges, District Attorney for Cleveland and Lincoln Counties. John was born and raised in Cleveland County and was employed by the Shelby Police Department for 18 years. For 20 years, he served with the Shelby Rescue Squad and has been very active at Mount Sinai Baptist Church. John has learned the values of the people in this area and endeavors to work with all law enforcement and community leaders to help make Cleveland and Lincoln Counties one of the best places in the state to live. On November 4th, make your vote count. For John Bridges, District Attorney for Cleveland and Lincoln Counties. This announcement paid for by Friends to Elect John Bridges. Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986.
Backfield, your quarterback scared, I see it in his eyes. Sent that receiver in motion, that's just a disguise. My linebackers, they stepping up.
Man, I'm sitting here ready for the show to start, and I don't have a microphone. It's just laying on the table.
I was getting ready to go ahead and jump in
there. Hey, we're back at the Witherspoon Insurance pregame show on KTCBroadcasting.com. I am Sam Davis, along with Terry Reinhart, here breaking down the different conferences this week. Yes, sir.
And don't forget our number, 704-482-1390. If you are in Cleveland County, Gaston County, 704-435-3297. And Lincoln County, 704-735-8071.
And we're going to get into the South Mountain Atlantic Conference now, and we're going to talk about that conference and several games in the league this week, four games actually. None really jump out at you as a game of the week quality game. It's you got mostly your upper tier teams against your lower tier teams, so you don't expect a lot of good quality games. Let's start off with East Rutherford travels over to number 2 Crest. Terry, East Rutherford comes in 2-3 in the conference. They are a 2A team, taking on the Crest Chargers. Crest won last year 35-14 after struggling up until the end of the first half. What's the lifetime record on this one?
Lifetime record, I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
I didn't look this one up. Okay. That's on me.
I know. But, I know back in the day, East Rutherford used to, back in the 70s, East Rutherford's a pretty good quality program, and they
sure
won several
did.
Of
but
those.
For East Rutherford tonight, I just think they're very well outmatched. Can they make a game of this? I think they can be in it by halftime. You know, Crest is used to putting people away by halftime.
Right.
I think East Rutherford can be in it by halftime, but I think Crest will pull away in the third and fourth quarters. Crest 8-0, 5-0, and I've said this all year long. I think they are the best 3AA team in the western part of North Carolina.
Right.
You know, and I'm even, how would I put that? Because you never know where North and Guilford's going to be placed, and they were over here last year, and Crest had to play them. But very tough team to play, very strong, very athletic at every position.
Well, East was just crushed by Shelby recently.
Yes, they was.
And the interesting thing about tonight's game is the Charger defense is only allowing 39 yards per game rushing, 39 on average. Less than 5 points a game scoring, and that includes the second halves when the other teams generally get a score against the backups. The Crest defense has not allowed a score in the first half of any game this year. So that's how they've really made their living, is holding people down, jumping out to a early lead, and then just basically cruising into the third quarter with the backups.
Now, what was you saying a minute ago, like or Kevin was saying, like they average like 5.2 points given up or something?
Overall, throughout the game, 4.9 points per game they've been given up. So right at 5.
Man.
But now East makes their living running the ball.
They do.
They're averaging 239 yards a game on the ground. They've got three running backs, which we've discussed earlier this year, Calvin Camp, Cam Garrison, and Sabian Ruff. These guys are all athletes. The Garrison kids, they're power back. Camp's their scat back that can absolutely fly. Coach Barnes said recently that if that Camp kid gets by us, we will not catch him. We do not have a player on the field that can catch him from behind. So the key is going to be keep Camp in front of you.
I don't know. I'm not going to say. I just think this game will get out of hand.
Yeah, I believe it will. Crest will shut down the run game, and East won't have anything else to do. They'll try to throw it, and then the Crest DBs will be just, you know, be like sharks in bloody water. But Crest should win that game very easily. Let's move over to Kings Mountain. Big upset loss last week. Wow. I called it an upset, but the folks that know RS say RS got their quarterback back from an injury, and RS was picked to be the top team in the county, in Rutherford County. But Kings Mountain, you get Brandon Bell back. You get Darian McClain back, your top quarterback and running back, and you expect, okay, time to roll.
Well, when I saw him come back, the first thing I always question when a guy comes back after injury, are you ready? Have you been brought back too soon? I mean, that's what I always ask. Were they brought back too soon? I can't answer that. Did they not have a great game? Maybe not.
They did
maybe,
not. They did
maybe
not.
Maybe this is the week that they fully, totally come back ready to play. Kings Mountain leads this series 22-13. Chase, you know, beat Kings Mountain last year 40-28.
They did. So, but now Chase was a good bit better last year.
They
and
were,
Kings Mountain
they
was
were.
On that dreadful 9-game losing streak to close out the year where everything fell apart. Injuries, suspensions, and the kids just quit. You could just tell by the way they closed out the year. When you lose to Drawn last year, you've quit.
Yeah, I agree.
And that's what they did. They lost to Drawn, Chase. They lost to everybody last 9 games. Won their first 2, I believe, and then lost their last 9. So that was it for Kings Mountain last year.
But this is the game that Kings Mountain's got to turn the table and start going in the right direction for the end of the year.
Yeah, they need to build some momentum going down the stretch. They're 6-3 on the year, guaranteed the number 2 3A spot, yes. I believe, in the conference. Chase is only averaging 3 points per game in their last three games. So the Kings Mountain defense, they take a lot of risks, a lot of chances. But with Chase, I got a feeling that they're going to shut them down. And Kings Mountain will look totally different this week from last week. Kings Mountain will look like world beaters this week as they defeat Chase. Agree?
I agree.
All right. All right. East Burke will travel over to RS Central. East Burke 2-6 on the year. RS Central 5-3, 3-2 in the conference. RS probably going to be the number 2-2A seed in the conference. It's between them and East when they'll battle it out at the end of the year. But
yeah. RS Central comes in. They've won the last five in this series. They're 5-3, 3-2. You know what? What a great year. I mean, they win tonight. They go to 6-3, 4-2 in the conference. Great. Fantastic. Tom Brown is going to be in his 485th career game tonight. I just don't think Tom's had enough time to change East Burke to where they are winners. I mean, they've kind of fell off the map. He's going to have at least two or three more years, you know, if he stays with it. That's my whole deal. Just give him a couple more years. I do not think that this will be a close game. RS Central wins going away.
Well, having seen East Burke play last year and this year, I can tell you that he's making a big impact. They are much improved from last year. They're still, the record-wise, it's 2-6, but yeah, they are a much better team. They're not getting crushed like they were last year.
The only problem I have with them is them turnovers.
Well, earlier in the year, they had a ton of them,
you know, and those things will always stay with you, and you got to, you know, you can't win any ball game with too many turnovers.
Right, I agree. Well, that's a game tonight that RS should win easily. And the last game in the South Mountain Atlantic Conference, and probably the big game, because Burns will travel over to take on Drawn. Burns needs this badly. They need this win. Losing the way they've done this year, they're 3-4 overall. They need this win over Drawn to become playoff eligible.
I do, and I think that'll make them 4-4, 4-2, Drawn. But here's your trap game. Remember last year we all had Kings Mountain making that trip over to Drawn, and look what happened. I hope this is not a trap game for Burns. I think Burns is a better quality football team in this series, and Burns should win tonight.
Well, last year Drawn was a little stronger than they are
this
year.
They were.
But still, as you said, Drawn did get a win this year. They beat Chase.
Yeah.
And now Chase has really went in the tank this year after beating R.J. Reynolds earlier this year. But Burns should get their fourth win, become playoff eligible. And I believe they still have East Burke on their schedule before the season's over. Crest and then maybe close out with East Burke. Or maybe it's not East Burke. No, they close out with East Rudd or R.S. Central. Hmm. So that will be their fifth game. Yeah, that'll be a tough one.
That'll be a tough one.
2 weeks from tonight, that will be a tough game against RS. But Burns does become eligible tonight. They would be the third 3A team in the conference. So I think the conference sends two automatically, and after that it's a wild card.
It is.
So Burns will be.
But you know, when you are in a conference that's 2A, 3A, and this split, there's a chance that most of your teams out of like a 2A or a 3A could become playoff eligible. You know, the problem I always have is when you in a straight 2A, and a lot of teams like that straight 2A, because, I mean, more teams get in, but the ones that are vying for that position in the middle, some of them are left out.
Well, let's talk about that as we wrap up the South Mountain Atlantic Conference. Let's talk about the bubble. Who's qualified? I gave you a form over there a little while ago. Who's qualified? Who's on the bubble? And as you were mentioning, the split conference. Now, over in the Big South 2A, 3A, not a lot of winning records over there. Actually, only one winning record in the whole conference, and that's Forest View. Hunter Huss is 2-6 on the year. But a win tonight assures them – well, I must not give it to you – assures them of the number one 2A seed in that conference. So if they only win three games this year, they will still qualify for the playoffs because they are the number one 2A seed.
That's what ends up putting a lot of teams last year, that we had teams with six wins that did not make it on account of the conference records.
Well, this is the problem with the current playoff system. Oh, you found it. Okay. Yes. I did give it to you. In the split conferences, you've got teams like Hunter Huss that in any normal year would not have a prayer of making the playoffs, but here they will because they get automatic bids regardless of their record.
Yes.
Now, that's just not fair to take a Hunter Huss and leave a West Lincoln home, and West Lincoln could end up being 5-5, and Huss could end up being 3-6.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just not fair. But that's the way the current system is, as much as I hate it. But it, I will say this, the current system, the split classifications and stuff, I like it to a point, because years ago you could be third in your conference at 9-1, have a three-way split for your conference title, and be 9-1 and not make the playoffs, because your conference only got two seeds.
Here's the problem I have with some of the things that set up. If you are the number one team, and I'm going to say Hunter Huss, like they was last year,
right?
And they had a ton of home games.
Yeah.
You know, I have a problem with that. You're the number one, and there's nothing we can do about it because that's how you qualified. But should you get that many straight home games like they had last year?
Well, the seeding process is the number one seed from the conference is going to the top four or five seeding. So them being the number one 2A from their conference got them about a number four or five seed.
It did.
Even with a horrible record. But now I will give them credit. They won two or three games last year in the playoffs, and they proved they did belong in the 2A playoffs last year. When you play in a tough conference like the Big South 2A, 3A, and you're losing Forest View, South Point, Ashbrook, those teams, it's nothing disrespectful about being 5-5 in a 2A split conference, but 3-6, I got a problem with that.
Well, I do. I mean, my whole deal is I always look at it, could have Hunter Huss defeated them teams on the road?
Yeah, possibly. Possibly not. Who knows? Well, the Big South 2A qualified on the bubble. Right now we've got three teams in this conference. Forest View, South Point, and Ashbrook all have the four wins to make the playoffs. No guarantee they will with those, but they have what they need to get there. East Gaston at 3-5, Hunter Huss at 2-6, and Lake Norman Charter at 3-5, and actually North Gaston at 3-5 are on the bubble.
And speaking of that, East Gaston plays North Gaston tonight. Both teams are 3-5. Huge game for both squads.
Right, both of them. One of those teams become bowl eligible. Bowl eligible, listen at me. Become playoff eligible.
Yes.
The only team in that conference that's out of the playoff runners here in week 10 is Stuart Kramer at 1-7.
They are.
But that has been a terribly mediocre conference this year. Not one team out there is a powerhouse, as in years past we've had. But now that the playoffs are coming around, you might see Forest View, South Point, and Ashbrook all win a few games, one or two games in the playoffs. Well, over in the Southern District 7, everybody is either eligible or on the bubble except for Bunker Hill.
And when you look at that conference, six out of the eight teams are 500 or above.
Yeah, and have the minimum four wins to make it to the playoffs. West Caldwell right now at 3-5. They've got to sneak one out in here in the last 3 weeks to become eligible. But as you said, in a straight 2A conference, you could end up 5-5.
Yeah, and the problem I have with this, a straight 2A conference, I think five teams going to go out of there. One of these that's in that middle pack is going to be left out.
But so 5-5, you might stay home in a 4-6 somewhere else that finishes second or third,
yes,
and their split conference could get in ahead of you.
Sure could.
Now, over in the Southern Piedmont 1A, you've got three teams right now that are qualified: Pine Lake Prep, Thomas Jefferson, Bessemer City, and Community School of Davidson's 3-5. Cherville's 2-6, but now this is where you have the anomaly in the 1A, 1AA. You've got teams, honestly, that will be going 1-9, making the playoffs, because they're going to pick all the way down the list till they get enough teams for the 1A playoffs. And you could have, as Cherville years ago was either 0-10 or 1-10, they made the playoffs.
How many games did Highland Tech win last year? One?
Yeah, if they won that
game. Yeah, one, maybe two. I think it was only one. But they were in the playoffs because they had to play Cherville in the first round, you know.
Well, that's where the joke occurs. And I understand the thinking behind this is that you've got teams
out
on the coast.
Enough teams.
You've got teams out on the coast that are have like 200 kids in the school playing against teams with 700 kids. Well, when you do the math, that's three times larger in the 1A, so it's tough to compete at those levels, and I understand that. But my goodness, people, wouldn't it be better to drop any team that doesn't have at least four wins, and instead of having 64 teams in the state playoffs or whatever that number is, you know, you've got 40 with some byes. Do that instead of making a team that went 1-9 this year go travel 300 miles to play a game and get beat 62-0. It cost them a lot more to play that game than they would ever make from the High School Athletic Association or at the gate.
And now you got to consider when you go to these games, especially in this 1A or 1AA, and it's a 42-point game. You know, when you make the playoffs, you're going to continue to pound until you get that lead. Some of these games are going to be over first quarter, very start of the second quarter,
right,
and the clock's going to be continue to run, and this game's going to be finished.
So you might travel 3 hours on a bus to play for about 30 minutes.
Yes,
when
that's
it's all
what
said
I'm
and
saying.
Done.
You know.
Yeah. All right, over in the South Mountain Atlantic, 2A, 3A, you've got a lot of competition. You've got a split conference. So you've got the three 3A teams, Crest, Burns, and Kings Mountain are all 3A. Those are the three teams. The two guaranteed spots in the conference go to the top two finishers in the conference, and right now that's Crest at 8-0 and Kings Mountain at 6-3. Burns is 3-2 in the conference, and Kings Mountain's 3-3. Burns still has to win one more. We expect them to get this tonight and to be eligible, so it's very likely all three of those teams could make the playoffs. Over in the 2A bracket, it gets really interesting. Then Shelby's a lock at 8-1, 6-0 in the conference. R Central's a lock at 5-3. And then it gets really interesting. East Rutherford's 4-4 right now. They're kind of on the bubble. They'll go to 4-5 tonight. So you've got three teams in the 2A division of the South Mountain Atlantic that are eligible or trying to be eligible. East Burke, no chance. Draw, no chance. Chase, no chance.
That's how I look at it. I think your bottom three teams have no chance. I think Shelby, R Central, and East Rutherford. East Rutherford does need another win, I think, to make sure they get in. But one more win by them, and they're in, and that's the three teams. Shelby, RS, and East Rutherford in. Crest, Burns, Kings Mountain are in.
Well, I would expect East Rutherford, I don't know who they close out with this year, but I'm sure it's got to be a East Burke or a Drawn or a Chase in there down the stretch. So they should get their fifth win somewhere along in there. Well, that's going to break down the on the bubble or qualified for right now. We've still got 3 weeks to go. A lot of things change. Yes, sir.
And don't forget about Crest breaking away from
us. Hey, good thinking there. It's 6:29, folks. And if you're a Crest Charger fan, they will be breaking away on KTCBroadcast.com to start their pregame show in about 30 seconds. And on that note, we're going to take a quick break and come back for the final segment and cover over the Big South 2A, 3A, and the Southern Piedmont 1A. Stick around.
To the Hawks, okay. We're gonna run it down their throat soon as we get the ball. I'll come out and fire off the ball, we going on one. My skill position so proficient, break for long runs. Come out running at option.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price. With names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986. Experience, not politics. That's what you get with District Attorney candidate Mike Miller. Since 1997, Mike Miller has been practicing law, including 12 as a prosecutor, 3 years as an NCIS agent, and 2 years of private practice. Mike Miller has tried hundreds of jury and non-jury trials, including armed robbery, kidnapping, and first-degree murder. And for the past 3.5 years, he has supervised the Lincoln County District Attorney Office. Experience, not politics, Mike Miller, candidate for District Attorney in Lincoln and Cleveland Counties. For more information, go to MikeMillerForDA.com. This announcement paid for by friends of Mike Miller.
Jamma J's Pizza Factory is Shelby's favorite locally owned family pizza restaurant, featuring a pizza buffet and salad bar, a fantastic game room, and birthday parties. Jamma J's has gluten-free pizza, vegan cheese pizza, and now try the La Nova wings in barbecue, hot and spicy, or oven roasted. And Jamma J's is the original home for the Livermuss pizza. Want to eat at home and watch the game? Call for carryout at 704-600-6182. Jamma J's Pizza Factory, Highway 74 East, behind the Golden Corral in Shelby.
When it comes time to cut the grass, you'll be more than happy to do it on your new Husqvarna Zero Turn Mower or Tractor Mower from Carolina Hardware and Garden Center in Lincoln. You'll find one that's right for your lawn and your pocketbook, and get free delivery of your new mower. And now is the time to service your old mower. Bring it on in or call for pickup and delivery. From parts to service to a brand new Husqvarna mower, they do it all at Carolina Hardware and Garden Center on the Reeseville Road in Lincoln, your Husqvarna dealer in this area. Hey, now's the time to see Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery in Lincolnton to get your home ready for the holidays. Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery specializes in custom-made interior decor with the skills and knowledge to assist you in creating beautiful custom-made furniture. See the wide array of colors and fabrics and get ready for the holidays now. See Carpenter's Furniture Upholstery, 1271 Hill Road in Lincolnton, open from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday through Friday. On November 4th, vote John Bridges, District Attorney for Cleveland and Lincoln Counties. John was born and raised in Cleveland County and was employed by the Shelby Police Department for 18 years. For 20 years, he served with the Shelby Rescue Squad and has been very active at Mount Sinai Baptist Church. John has learned the values of the people in this area and endeavors to work with all law enforcement and community leaders to help make Cleveland and Lincoln Counties one of the best places in the state to live. On November 4th, make your vote count for John Bridges, District Attorney for Cleveland and Lincoln Counties. This announcement paid for by Friends to Elect John Bridges.
Hi, I'm Judith Light, and I'm here for my flu shot. Did you know there's an option for people 65 and older? Flu season is here, and people 65 and older need to ask about the vaccine made specifically for our age. Flu vaccination is especially important for people with chronic conditions like diabetes and heart disease, which can worsen with the flu. Visit the National Council on Aging at ncoa.org/flu to learn more and talk to your doctor about vaccine options for people 65 and older.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents, Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986.
And we're back at the KTCBroadcasting.com Witherspoon Insurance pregame shoe. And don't forget to stop by Witherspoon Insurance next time you're in Shelby and say hey to Wayne and Justin and the crowd over there. We thank them for sponsoring our show. Each and every year, they've been a pregame show sponsor now for quite a while.
Yes, they have, and anything that you need, jump in there. They got insurance for about anything that you might want.
Yeah, and I don't believe they got any geckos or lizards in there, but they'll be straight up with you.
That's exactly, and that's what you look for
in your hometown insurance man. They are an independent insurance agent, so they're not bound by a company that forces them to sell. Terry, I'm tangled up in my cables here, and I got stuff flying everywhere. Okay, don't forget, Crest left at 6:30, but I've just been informed they will be on WOHS tonight and 1390 AM as Shelby has the night off. So the Crest pregame show will be internet only until 7 o'clock, and then at 7 o'clock they will be internet and radio on 1390. And briefly, let's go over that real quickly, the KTC broadcasting lineup tonight. Some pretty good games. Hunter Huss over at Kramer Storm, Brent Pascoe and Derek Smith. Lincolnton travels to Newton Conover for the game of the night for me. David Kiever and Rick Mitchum will bring you that action, and they've done a bang-up job this year. Love hearing from those guys. Shelby, again, is open. Burns travels to Drawn with Calvin Hastings and Dan Greer, and I want to add one comment there. A lot of people that listen to the show see Calvin throughout the community every week because he makes a lot of calls on people. When you see Calvin next week, ask him, Calvin, got a tripod in your trunk? And I'll bet you he says yes. But Calvin Hastings and Dan Greer will be covering the Burns at Drawn game. East Rutherford travels over to Crest with Rob Roop, Tim Foster, and Andy Foster. And on the radio.
That's right. On WCSL 1590, it's Pine Lake Prep against Cherryville. On WOHS 1390, East Rutherford will visit over to Crest. And WLON 1050, it's that game we keep talking about, Lincolnton at Newton Conover.
Game of the week. And let's talk about the Big South 2A, 3A conference, Terry. The game in that conference, you've got a number two actually now against number one, so I guess it technically would be almost like a game of the week. It has more importance than the Southern District 7 game we've been calling the game of the week. Although I have to say, those Southern District 7 games, there's a certain je ne sais quoi flair about those games. You could take the number three team against the number five team, and you're going to have a very exciting, entertaining game.
Well, you go back into that, and West Lincoln played Newton Conover, final score 48-41. You know, and that was your number two team playing like your number five team.
And then Wes Lincoln plays Wes Caldwell, and it's just 28-24. So it's an exciting, entertaining game.
Yes, it is.
So all that whole conference has been very entertaining. But tonight's game, Ashbrook travels over to Forest View. Ashbrook 4-4 on the year, struggled in the non-conference, struggled mightily, but they're 3-1 in conference, which is the most important thing right now. Forest View undefeated. Forest View coming off a big 34-31 overtime win over South Point. And I texted you during that game when it was going to overtime, and I told you Forest View will not have a chance to win this game if it makes it to overtime. They will not be able to stop that
the Red Bone offense,
but by golly, they did.
They did, to a field goal, and what a difference that made. Then I think it was either the first play, second play, Mo Neal went in for the touchdown to finish it.
Second
play.
And I am beginning to see the hype on Mo Neal after watching him play that. He don't run for, 300 yards a game, but I'm seeing what the college recruiters and scouts are seeing in him. He's got that flair about him. When he ran that touchdown run, I don't think South Point had a chance to stop him. He's going to be an amazing kid, and he's just a junior.
Yes, he is. This game last year, though, 2013, speaking of 34-31, Ashbrook won last year's game 34-31. Amazing. Ashbrook leads this series 10-3, but this is a total different Forest View team. I was very impressed with this Forest View team at the very start of the year when they went down to South Carolina and won a few games.
Right.
And now I think they end up losing a couple right there, right in the middle, but now they have bounced back. So I think Forest View will be a tough squad to beat tonight.
Well, they lost to a very good East Lincoln squad.
They did. Well, 40-33.
Right.
I mean, it come down to the very end of that game.
And although East Lincoln's 2A, East Lincoln is the number 2 2A team, so that really balances it out there. But Forest View, Ashbrook's much improved this year, but Forest View, I feel like they're going to win that game tonight and basically claim the title.
They will.
We've got a caller on the line. Hello, caller.
How's it going? It's Tom Centofanti.
Mr. Centofanti. Tom is the host of the Rinaldo Auto Mall postgame show. Tom, how are you tonight?
Pretty good. I was just enjoying listening to you guys talk a little Gaston County football. And I think Ashbrook's got a shot tonight. I think that's going to be an interesting battle there. Forest View better not look past them or they might go down tonight. But I'm assuming that's our Gaston County game of the week.
It is.
Okay, I mean, that's a good one, and just want to remind everybody, if it's the Gaston County Game of the Week, they can watch that on KTC Broadcasting,
and I'll follow along, especially if
you can't make it out to a game, and, you can take it in your pocket with a Ustream app, so I'll be looking forward to catching some of that game.
Hey,
Burns is up at Drone tonight, so I can't make it up there and make it to the station, so I'll be flipping around on KTC watching these ball games.
Hey, Tom, we made an error there. It is not the game of the week. It should be, but due to scheduling conflicts, Hunter Huss at Stuart Kramer is our Gaston County game of the week. But you're right. That's going to be a great game, that Ashbrook at Forest View game.
Yeah, I'd actually, if I had time, I'd like to get down there and take a peek at that one and just see how Forest View holds up as the favorite in that conference. Now, the big win over South Point last week, I mean, that's just a huge win for their program. But sometimes after you get that huge win, you relax a little bit, and that's just a natural human tendency. So I'm interested to see if they get surprised with Ashbrook tonight.
Well, go ahead,
Tom. We was talking before. Ashbrook was the preseason favorite, so here's their chance to say, okay, you know what, we haven't been forgotten. So a win by them tonight, and what a difference that'll make in that conference.
And Gaston County is kind of like Cleveland County. If you don't prepare and don't have the right mindset, you have a good chance of getting beat.
Oh, so, that's absolutely true.
That is the most intriguing matchup of the night, and that of the Newton-Conover game. I know a lot of folks around the Burns area still like keeping up with Matt Beam, and if they're not going to make it up the Drone, if they're going to watch the game on KTC, we've also got Newton-Conover on KTC tonight.
Yes,
That's a big ball game, and I'm interested to see. I've been following Newton Conover a little bit, and Terry, I know we've talked about it in the station. They seem to have some problems slowing folks down. I know I watched them with West Lincoln, and Mac George had a pretty good ball game. West Lincoln's got a good bit of offense, and I want to say that West Lincoln put up 41, and that was one of those wild 47-41 games. They had a 60-50 game with West Caldwell. Last week with East Lincoln, not as many points scored, but it's going to be interesting tonight to see how the Newton Conover defense holds up.
Well, they were in the game with East Lincoln until third quarter. And then East Lincoln just, you know, like a machine, they just continue to score. And if you fumble or turn the ball over or have to punt, you're just falling behind with East Lincoln.
And they've got in East Lincoln's got so many weapons. You know, the Surratt brothers, Valentine, you know, that offense really can get it done. And, you know, the big eaters in the trenches, I've watched them. It looks like they do a good job protecting their quarterback and open up some holes, too. So the unsung hero, the offensive line, it looks like really that whole offensive unit for East Lincoln is really doing well. And not surprising that, you know, I thought they would get past Newton Conover last week. But I'm also interested to see how Newton Conover rebounds from that first loss of the year. And I think that put him at 6-1. I know that if I'm wrong, Terry will correct me.
Yeah,
but it's a pretty impressive start for them, despite their struggles on defense. So that's going to be an intriguing matchup tonight. I'll be watching as much of that as I can. And hopefully we can get some folks from Lincoln County to call in and tell us about that Newton Conover game.
Well, question for you, Tom. After last week, I know Burns, it's a county rivalry game with Shelby. You go into the game with nothing but expectations and high hopes. Burns went into that game for half a quarter. They were competitive, but then Shelby just turned it on. How was the mood this week?
I want to say that Burns had the lead after one quarter, if I remember correctly. And then things quickly went south. That Shelby team's just very explosive. Okay. And the defense is, you know, a very, very good defensive unit. So, you know, it didn't surprise the result of that game in the end didn't surprise me.
Right.
It seemed like the morale of the boys is pretty much intact. Right. They're still working hard. Got a few of them in my class. One of them was Bryson Allen, number 30, and Brent Pasco was going on about how well he played. And that kid, he likes to hit, and you got to love a football player that likes to hit. And they've got some boys up there, Burns, like him that like to hit, like to play football. I mean, they love the game, and they know that Shelby had the better team, and it seemed to me like they had good attitudes. They went back to work. I talked to the coaching staff, and, you know, like all coaching staffs, they're a little tight-lipped. When they get around somebody who's with the media, they get a little tight-lipped.
Right.
They don't want to tell me everything. They're scared I might slip up and say something I shouldn't. But as far as I could tell, they've still got morale up, and they're pretty confident they should get a win at Drone this week. Next week against Crest, well, we all know Crest is loaded and they're very good, and Crest could be heavily favored in that game against Burns next week on Halloween. But if you get to the next week, that first week in November when they play RS Central, that's going to be the do-or-die game for Burns. That's going to be the one that gets them in the playoffs or not.
Right.
So hopefully they stay healthy and they can get past RS and get in the playoffs.
Well, we're looking forward to that. We're hoping mightily that they do get by Drawn, which we know they will, and then the RS game, as you said, is going to be the big one. Well, Tom, we got another caller on the line. Thank you so much for calling. We really enjoy your perspective on the games, and we'll look forward to hearing from you and Dennis Davis on the Renato Auto Mall postgame show coming up right here. All right, thank you, Tom. And we have another caller on the line. Go ahead, caller.
Sam.
Yes.
Sam. Come on, man. You can't shut your body up. That guy was vaccinated with the phonograph needle.
It was getting funny. It was to the point where I was, okay, well, Tom, let me just say, Tom. who's on the line?
Oh, by the way, he has a co-host on that post-game show, too, Sam, you know. Anyway, we give Tommy a hard time. He does like to talk a little bit. He's, I don't know, he's a great guy.
Man,
he really helps out with you guys on the pre-game show.
Oh,
and I'm just glad to work with him on the post-game show. But Tom is a hoot, and I encourage all the folks to call in tonight. We want the Burns folks to call in so they can tell us about their victory over Drone tonight. And the Crest fans, I'm just parking at the field house for the Crest-East Rutherford game. So we'd like to hear from some Crest folks and some East Rutherford folks, since we don't get to hear from the Rutherford County folks as much, this would be a good night for them to call in. Or the Chase Kings Mountain people, that might be a good call for those folks to make.
Well, I know you need to hear from all of them, because you got to find out what actually went on in the show so you can discuss it and give Tom some talking points, because he gets so shy and introverted. And
yeah, no, it's hard to bring him out of that shell.
But as you noticed tonight, Dennis, once he gets out of that shell, just back out of the way. Let him go, because he makes outstanding points.
He does. Tom is he's a sharp guy, and we're just proud to have him on the post-game show. He brings a certain element to us that maybe that other guy that's on there, me, doesn't bring. And Kevin's been working a few games, so it looks like it's going to be me and Tom and Terry and Steve tonight.
Yeah, well, Kevin's not doing a game tonight, so he'll be hanging around the studio running, getting food and stuff for you guys for your post-game meal and doing, you know, what he's been bred to do, serve the show.
Yep.
Well,
I'll let you guys go. And Terry's probably got three or four scores already, but we'll hold off on those. And I'll catch you guys a little bit later tonight. Tune in Ronaldo Auto Mall post-game show.
And that's Dennis Davis along with Tom Centofani and Terry Reinhart that will be bringing you the post-game scores, recaps, interviews, phone calls, and some expert analysis. And I use that term loosely, the expert analysis. All right, we got a quick break. We're going to take our last break, and we'll come back and close out the show. Stick around.
We in the trenches. You like the water cooler. You be on the benches. Think your team better, but they lack skill.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986. Experience, not politics. That's what you get with District Attorney candidate Mike Miller. Since 1997, Mike Miller has been practicing law, including 12 as a prosecutor, 3 years as an NCIS agent, and 2 years of private practice. Mike Miller has tried hundreds of jury and non-jury trials, including armed robbery, kidnapping, and first-degree murder. And for the past 3.5 years, he has supervised the Lincoln County District Attorney Office. Experience, not politics, Mike Miller, candidate for District Attorney in Lincoln and Cleveland Counties. For more information, go to MikeMillerForDA.com. This announcement paid for by friends of Mike Miller. Planning to buy another vehicle? Then plan to stop at Oak Grove Auto Sales in Kings Mountain. On the lot this week, you'll find a 2013 Kia Rio LX under a manufacturer's warranty and only 23,000 miles for just $12,999. Or a 2008 BMW 550i with sports package, now at a Cleveland County Fair special price of $1,000 off. Or take a look at a 2004 Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo 4x4 for $63.99. And for luxury, a 2007 Mercedes-Benz E350. It's below NADA price at $13,995. Oak Grove Auto Sales on the Oak Grove Road between Shelby and Kings Mountain.
I'm Lon Helton, inviting you to join me as I count down the week's top 30 with Jason Aldean, who's battling with tour mates Florida Georgia Line for number one.
Uh-oh, it may be a battle this weekend on tour then. Depends on who's sitting in front of who has bragging rights this weekend. It could get interesting.
That's Jason Aldean this week on Country Countdown USA.
Country Countdown USA with Lon Helton, Friday afternoons 1 to 4, right here at Big O Country and online at kdcbroadcasting.com. Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986.
Your back's in the backfield. Your quarterback scared, I see it in his eyes. Sent that receiver in motion, that's just a disguise.
And we're back at the Witherspoon Insurance pregame show right here on KTCBroadcasting.com. Sam Davis and Terry Reinhardt at 6:51. We'll be breaking away for the pregame shows about 6:57, 6:58, right along in there. So we've got a few more minutes. And just to finish up the Big South 2A, 3A conference, we talked about the Ashbrook Forest View. And also tonight, East Gaston travels over to take on North Gaston. Both of those teams looking for a win to get it playoff eligible.
Big game here, 3-5, 3-5, 2-2 in the conference, 1-3 in the conference. Huge game for both squads.
And East Gaston's non-conference schedule, I believe, prepares them, and they'll
this
win over
this year. It
the
really
Wildcats.
Did. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
South Point travels over to lick their wounds and take on poor Lake Norman Charter. South Point will take out last week's frustrating loss to Forest View on poor Lake Norman Charter, and you look for 40, 50 points from South Point tonight.
Well, last year it was 55-0. Look for the same thing this year.
I agree.
Lake Norman Charter is on the bottom in offense and defense.
And so South Point's going to make a point to try to build some confidence back up tonight. Hunter Huss travels over Stuart Kramer. Again, Huss 2-6. A win tonight guarantees them the number one seed, 2A seed in the Big South Conference at 3-6.
It will. Quarterback Andrew Jordan leading the way. Hunter Huss should win.
Yeah, win with ease. Might add that there. And now let's close out the last six, seven minutes. We're going to talk about the Southern Piedmont 1A. Last week we didn't have time. We ran out of time and didn't get to talk to them. But this week we've got two really good games, competitive games. Bessemer City travels to Thomas Jefferson, where we touched on that with Lewis earlier. Bessemer City 2-0 in the conference. Thomas Jefferson 2-0.
The winner takes a step up in the conference race. The loser will fall down into a tie with the second game that we've got on our schedule.
Terry, this game here, honestly, I think tonight this game decides the conference. Now, I know you'll disagree with Cherville on the horizon for Bessemer City should Bessemer City win tonight, but honestly, from what I've seen out of Cherville, I think Pine Lake Prep's a little bit of an unknown because of their non-conference record, the teams they played, the JVs and private school, not private school, what do you call them, homeschooled kids, yeah. People like that. But I think tonight's winner, Thomas Jefferson, Bessemer City, I think they clinch.
Well, the thing that gets me with Cherville, they lost two wide receivers. They've got both of them back now. Grant Henderson's running the show again, and you got a Cherville team that took a little lumps, but look who they were playing, Parkwood, West Lincoln. Teams that are a little step up above them, They are finally back down to playing 1A squads, and I think you
That's
take
true.
Cherville
Very
and
true.
Pull off a win tonight, and I said they set up a matchup on down to, well, the race with Bessemer City, if Bessemer City can pull off a win over Thomas Jefferson.
Well, I expect Cedric Mackey and Tyler Bess of Bessemer City to flex their muscles tonight and probably come out with a win, but Thomas Jefferson likes to throw the ball.
They do.
This could be a very competitive game. Well, Pine Lake Prep, 5-2 on the year, 1-1 in the conference. They travel over to Cherville tonight,
exactly.
Which you
Big
can
game.
Hear that game right here on WCSL, 1590 AM. Cherville needs a win if they want a shot, any kind of shot at the conference title.
They do. If you lose here, well, playoff, you're still probably in it.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, as you know, you're in the 1A. So just you're hurting your scene of who you might have to go play.
Well, the matchup, Cherville quarterback Grant Henderson, 1,459 yards and 14 touchdowns so far this year. And most of that with hardly any protection. What I understand, he scrambles every week.
Exactly.
The leader for Pine Lake Prep, running back Austin Cook, has 1,000 yards already and 12 touchdowns. So it looks like you're going to have a passing team in Cherville against a running team in Pine Lake Prep. I think if Henderson can get some protection, Cherville should win this game.
I'm looking for a lot of points in this game.
Yeah, very, very likely. Could be a very entertaining game. And the last game in the Southern Piedmont 1A, Community School of Davidson. They're 3-5 overall, although they're 0-2 in the conference this year. Now, they travel to Highland Tech and take on the 0-8 Rams, 0-2 in the conference. Community School won last year 42-6.
Yeah, 42-6. Highland Tech comes in here for running back, quarterback Josh Crawford, leading the way for all of them, 922 yards, 8 touchdowns. This guy's got to have a huge night for Highland Tech to come up with an upset.
Well, I don't think Highland Tech's actually come close to beating anybody yet this year, but Crawford, moving him to quarterback after they lost their starting quarterback a couple weeks ago, they've moved Crawford and basically said, we're going to hand it to you anyway, so you might as well just take it to start with. Crawford left, Crawford right, Crawford up the middle, punt. So,
yes.
But he'll get his yards, but in the end, Community School of Davidson should come out on top. And the last game that we want to mention over in Lincoln County, North Lincoln, although they're not in any of the area conferences, they are in that northern Piedmont 3A-4A, which is a killer conference.
Well, Lake Norman comes in with Ladowski, the quarterback, tremendous guy. He's probably going to lead the way. North Lincoln, look for a long night.
Hey, this kid, I was looking at some stats earlier today on him. He's like ran for 1,000 yards already,
oh, yes.
And he's thrown for 2,000.
He did the same thing last year.
And he's got a Polish name, so that makes it all the more interesting because he's not your typical triple threat quarterback.
And you're looking for a battle on down the road that's still wait to you know still going to happen. Lake Norman and Mooresville.
Yeah, well, Mooresville's what number four in the 4A polls,
oh, yeah.
And Lake Norman they're a 3A team or 4A.
Lake Norman's 3A.
So that should be a great showdown coming up. But Richard Jackson, the running back for North Lincoln, averages 102 yards. And I will say this, North Lincoln lives and dies by the run.
They
only average around 30 yards a game passing. So their goal is to run.
Yeah, time of possession is huge in
right.
this game.
But in the end, I believe, I agree with you there, Lake Norman stays perfect in the conference as they move toward a showdown with 4A Mooresville. One thing I do want to say is Andre will be at Newton Conover Lincoln game tonight taking pictures for the What's Up Shopper.
He will.
And so be sure to check out his pictures in the What's Up Shopper and online. And before we leave here, it's time to go. We want to take one more moment and thank the folks over at the Parkway House Family Restaurant right here in Cherville. They've got a to-go menu for lunch and dinner, and they serve an awesome breakfast from what I've been told. 704-769-8055. Thank them for providing our pregame meal. Great food, great people. They're open 7 days a week.
They are. Great that place
is
to
eat. The Parkway House Family Restaurant here in Cherville. Well, folks, that's going to do it for tonight. We've covered every single game this week. Ran out of time last week, but this week we got them all in. Thank you for listening. We look forward to talking with you next week as the bubbles start bursting for some of these teams, Terry.
Sure will.
And we'll see you next week. Go to a game tonight. Enjoy the evening.
We in the trenches. You like the water cooler. You be on the benches. Think your team better, but they lack skill. First snap, I leave your backs in the backfield. Your quarterback scared, I see it in his eyes. Sent that receiver in motion, that's just a disguise. My linebackers, they stepping up. Clog a hole, no letting up. Taking on no big blocks. On fourth down, we get big stops. My secondary is balling out. Your offense keeps stalling out. How many yards? Like none at all. Call the special teams, come punt the ball, and it's gone. Never see me fair catch. Go. I get a block and then I'm gone like a Learjet. Go. My helmet on, pass strap tight. Yeah. My jersey shining in them Friday night lights. Yeah. Win. We just came to win. Win. We just came to win. Friday night lights. Ballin' Friday night lights. Ballin' win.
Call 704-487-8068.
Crash with a 42-0. Bradley's on West 6th and Boulevard brings us our weekly visit with Coach Marv Barnes. And last Friday night, crash with a 42-0 road victory at East Burke. The Chargers record their fourth shutout of the season.
Yeah, we didn't start out very well. You know, we had a bad snap and then had a couple penalties, and we actually recovered from the bad snap from, I don't remember, like a second and 33 or something, and we ended up converting that, and then we had a couple penalties stopped us, and defense stayed on the field a little bit long the first drive, and they missed the field goal, and then we got the engine revving a little bit and started moving the ball offensively and playing better defense. But it was a good win for us still. You know, they're a much improved football team. We knew they were going to be there. Their physical makeup was going to be a challenge for our defense because they were big and they were going to try to pound the football on us. And when that happens, you're going to get less snaps offensively, obviously, because the other team is playing slower and trying to stay on the field longer. But you got to make sure that you capitalize on all your opportunities.
As has been the case recently, Trey Harbison, another big night on the ground for you.
Yeah, we knew Trey was going to be good. I mean, you know, he had played for us as a sophomore and been in big, meaningful games. And so, you know, he's come on his own now and you know, he's getting a few more carries each Friday night and has established himself as our dominant back, obviously. You know, with that, when our tailback's successful, you know, I told you, I think a couple weeks ago, football is an original game from the standpoint that the guy that's actually getting attention very rarely is the guy who causes the good things to happen. It's generally somebody else. And most of the time, that's our offensive line and Jacob Camp at tight end and doing a good job blocking it. But then Trey, what has been impressive about Trey the last 3 to 4 weeks is the physical nature in which he's carrying the football. He's finishing runs, he's getting yards after contact, and using his body size is a big plus for him.
Willie Green II, another good night throwing the ball for you.
Yeah, we did a lot of quick screens, a lot of shovel passes, and the thing I did a bad job of Friday night is we've got to stretch the field some vertically with some passing game. We've got to show the ability to get over top of people and get them off of us a little bit, and then I allowed them Friday night to play too close to the line of scrimmage against us. But, you know, we threw the ball well, caught the ball well for the most part, had some receivers that made some very athletic plays after catches to extend drives for us. I remember Traquan doing that one time on a – it was really a sprint route. We sprinted out to the left, and it didn't work out. And we just got it down to him, and he made a couple people miss him. He ended up getting the first down, and we go on and score on that drive. So, you know, that's what we believe this year that is a little bit different from years in the past, that we do have guys that can throw the football. We got guys that can catch it. So now you've got to defend more athletes in space than what we've done previously.
Marlon Vinson came in the second half and had a good night running for you, scored a touchdown.
Malik Vinson, yeah. Malik has done a great job for us this year as a backup running back, you know, and casual couldn't play last Friday because of a team policy, and we look forward to getting him back this week. But Malik's a junior who has earned his carries and has done a good job practicing. He's consistent every week, and it was very rarely on Friday night do I actually go congratulate somebody for scoring a touchdown, but Friday night was one of those occasions where he got the score, and I was really happy for him. And Chris Willis on the block punt where he picked it up, ran it for touchdown. Now, those are two guys in our program who do things right on a consistent basis. They represent our community and our football program in a positive light in everything they do. So it's always good to see those guys get rewarded.
Speaking of the return by Chris Willis, second week in a row that you had a defensive lineman make a big play for you and show their speed on the field.
Yeah, Chris and, of course, Omar, I'm sure, is the one you're talking about the week before. Both of those guys they play defensive end for us, but they're linebacker type people. That, you know, neither one of them are 6'4". They're both, you know, 6'1", 6'2" guys that are anywhere from 210 to 225 guys. But both of those guys are great athletes. So when they get their hands on the ball, it's not like a defensive lineman's got it. It's like a linebacker or a DB's got it.
Defensively, speaking of Chris Willis, had another solid game up front for you, and Roseboro came in from the secondary and made several tackles.
Yeah, Dominique, it was a good night for Dominique because Dominique's always been a physical safety. And, you know, even back to when he was a freshman, you know, it was natural for him to feel and get in the box and make plays from the secondary. So, I thought we played well defensively. There weren't as many exciting, explosive plays, but by nature of what they do offensively, they're going to eliminate some of those, and it's going to play in a more confined area. So, you know, I thought Chris played well. I thought Dominique played well. I thought our front seven as a group played well. And the other thing that gets lost in games like that is your DBs. Instead of it being a spread game where they're getting challenged a lot of a high percentage of the time now, your defense on passes happen very rarely. But they catch you by surprise. And in years past, we've given up plays in that situation. Friday night, we didn't. Our DBs did a great job of staying true to what their job was on each play. And East Burke actually had been very successful in video of throwing the ball against people, although they didn't throw it very often. It was catching them by surprise and, letting good athletes get loose. And we did a great job of containing that phase of it.
Speaking of Dominique, he had a fumble recovery and an interception for you.
Yeah, Dominique has a way. You know, he's done that for 4 years. Well, 3 years, the year he wasn't hurt. One year he was hurt, but the ball finds him, and that's a big compliment to him. Some people think when you say that, well, you're just saying he's lucky. That's not the case. He's always around the football, and he takes advantage of his situations and causes turnovers. Worth the thing, he might also block the punt too. So he had two or three real big plays for us, and like you said, he did a great job fielding the running game and being physical.
Kicking game, Trey Odo, a good job kicking the ball into the end zone again. He had a couple of field goal attempts that were in his range, but not able to connect on them.
Yeah, it wasn't Trey Odo's best night. He still did a good job controlling field position for us, but he did miss some field goals. A lot of that is, we gave him Monday off and then it rained Tuesday. So, his week wasn't normal. We didn't have as many practices with him kicking balls with. And all that's timing and confidence. When Trey Odo's confident and his timing's right, he's as good as you'll ever have. And all you got to do is mess up just a little bit and you don't feel as comfortable. And he did not look comfortable on those two field goal attempts. Obviously, when Trey Odo misses one, it's not because of leg strength. We're not asking to kick one that he can't get there. He just didn't hit those two solid. But like you said, he did a good job on kickoff. And kickoffs were challenging because of their field. Their field was so had such a big crown on it that, when you're approaching the tee, you're actually running uphill a little bit. And, we just told him pregame to find some spots that were semi-level and where he could feel comfortable approaching the ball, and he did a good job for us.
All right, Coach, back home tonight, another SMAC conference encounter. East Rutherford Cavaliers come in. An East Rutherford team that's been up and down, but they have a lot of good athletes.
They do. They got four or five guys that can really run. And Coach Bland does a good job of getting the ball in those guys' hands. They're the group from Rutherford County that year in, year out, I think, has the type of skill players that we have in Cleveland County. They're very explosive offensively. It's like you said, that it seems like some weeks they're just not clicking on all their cylinders, and then other weeks they do look explosive. And the common thread for them, though, is if you can get them down, their players seem not to, I don't know what the right word to say
respond
is. Respond the right way sometimes. I know they're well coached. Coach Bland does a good job, but that's a big difference sometimes between winning games and losing games, or staying in games and making them competitively. And they've shown signs certain games that when that happens, it kind of snowballs on them and the games get out of it. And then in other games, they fight and they do a good job of clawing and getting themselves back in the game. We went and watched the Burns game in person. That was a very competitive game. Burns scored late to win the game, but it was a nip and tuck game back and forth the whole way. Probably East should have probably been ahead a little bit when they got to the fourth quarter, but Burns did a great job of staying in the game and then making plays at the end of the game to win it.
This East Rutherford team last season, they got a lead on you in the game over at East Rutherford.
Yeah, they did. We kind of it was first cold night, if I remember correctly. It was first cold night, and maybe our players weren't prepared for it, but we didn't play well early, and they did. And all of a sudden, you look in there at halftime, it's 14-14, I think, and then we came out in the second half, we're a little more dominant. So, that'll be something I'll remind our players of Friday right before we walk out.
Defensively, this East Rutherford team, as we mentioned about being up and down, they played some pretty good defense at times this season.
They do. Anytime I think they've got big guys too, but they've got good athletes on the perimeter. And when you got team speed on defense, it's hard to pop big plays on and give up big plays. So, their secret to what they do is not far off what we do. They've got guys who can run. They utilize them on both sides of the ball. Very similar to what we did last year. You're going to see the same number of guys a lot play both sides for them, which means they probably don't have as much depth as we do, and we need to make that an issue. We need to play fast offensively and try to make it a game where there's 170 snaps in it instead of a game where there's 130 snaps in it and try to make them play more. But they're a very good football team. They just You know, they're the team that, you know, like you said, sometimes you look at them and you say, that don't even look like the same team. And then the next week you say, yeah, that's what we're expecting. So we generally, I think, if you look over history, get their best shot. So it's a very important game for them. So we're expecting them to come in and play well, and we're going to have to fight hard to beat them.
What about special teams for the Cavaliers?
They got a really good kicker. You know, their guy, you know, kickoffs, he's going to kick some of them 6 yards deep in the end zone, then it's going to land on three. We like those kind of kickers. They've got confidence in them, so they're going to kick the ball off to you. And then if they miss, then you get the ball down to one or two, and you get a chance to, you know, they're a long ways away from your good athlete. So now I think leg strength wise, Trejo, him, and the young man at Shelby are very comfortable. You know, Trejo's been a little more consistent than the guy from East Rutherford, but he certainly has the ability to pin you back if you don't do a good job in a return game.
I understand this is senior night tonight for the Chargers, and talk about these seniors that have had great careers here at Crest.
Yeah, we moved senior night up a week because the Shelby game is, you know, there's so many people here, and it's just hard to do it that night. So we're doing it against East Rutherford, and you know, this group has been good. They've won a lot of ball games. They've been very successful, whether when they were on the JV team or now that they're on the varsity team. And you know, the thing we ask our classes every year is to make sure you leave the program in better hands than you got it in. And obviously this group has done that. And, you know, it'll be a hard group to replace. There's a lot of good players. There's a lot of good people in this class. So they've been a good group and a special group. And hopefully we'll just continue to move on this year and make it be something that they'll remember.
Physically, how are you coming into tonight?
We're a little beat up, you know, more from practice this week than last week's game. You know, we were a little more physical this week in practice. I just feel like we need to shake things up a little bit because we've been kind of stagnant for 2 weeks, and you know, that's not a quality that we like here. We want to make sure we're on the upward move, and so we try some different things in practice, and when you are more physical in practice, you're going to be a little more banged up on Friday. But you know, hopefully everybody will get to play. Our biggest question mark is Jabari Foster pulled his groin a little bit, and Aaron's got a little shoulder issue. So those two are guys that we're not sure about. We've had a lot of players sick this week. Omar's been sick. Jared Brooks has been sick. So you know, Miss Tavion Brentley hadn't been at practice all week because of illness. So you know, we better be deep because we're getting ready to play with some guys this Friday that don't normally play as many snaps. But we have a lot of confidence in those guys. Think they're going to play well. Offensively, the good sign is most of all those guys are healthy. And David Grant, who we pretty much felt like was going to be done for the year, is out practicing now with a knee brace on, and has really surprised us the last 2 weeks being able to hold up. You know, we're going to play. I think we're going to play three guys at center Friday and three guys at tackle Friday. And you know how we are. We're trying to find that right mix before the games start meaning the most. But, you know, so health-wise and a total scheme of things is really good for this time of year.
What's some keys to stay unbeaten and win another big conference game tonight?
Well, I mean, number one is understand how important the game is. Neutralize their speed because they do have guys that – you know, they're number 3, number 24, number 21, number 7. Any of those guys get loose on us, we're going to have a hard time. We're going to have a hard time catching them. So we've got to be more exact about what we do in special teams and on defense. And you know, it's the same formula always. Make them turn it over. Don't turn it over. We've got to reduce our number of penalties on both sides of the ball, defensively and offensively, and be good in special teams. But, you know, you know, just know how important the game is. And then the other thing, obviously, is we need to make the game be a as many snap game as we can. Don't. That's what they did.
Two medium cappuccinos.
Let's show them what a breakfast with whole grain fiber can do.
I have two cappuccinos, medium macchiato, two espressos, one with a double shot.
That's not the coffee talking.
Start your day with Kellogg's Frosted Mini Wheat Cereal. It's a delicious way to get the nutrition you want.
Hey, Tony. Dad, go wide. Set.
Hi.
Yeah! Touchdown!
Yeah! Nice catch. Who's ready for halftime?
Yes!
Okay, I'm going to draw something out new. Wide receiver goes deep all the way to the corner. Wait a minute.
Wait, the quarterback.
Share what you love with who you love. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
They're great!
Our weekly visit with Coach Mark Barnes brought to you by Bradley's on West Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. And we welcome in our listeners now with us on WOHS 1390 AM tonight. Glad to have you along. Of course, Shelby normally on 1390 each Friday night, the Golden Lions with the week off.
And we want to bring you back into our stadium pregame show. Cleveland Regional Medical Center, the sponsor. Great to have you along as we are now just about 15 minutes away from kickoff as Crest and East Rutherford to get ready to do battle. And, Andy, you heard Coach Mark Barnes talk about the fact that, and we mentioned earlier in our pregame show, East Rutherford's got a lot of speed. We mentioned that, a lot of weapons, and defensively they're going to have to counter that tonight. And he also mentioned the fact, of course, this game a year ago, remember, was 14-14 at the half. East Rutherford really played Crest well, and Crest certainly would love to get out to a much better start here against them in 2014.
You know, the Cavaliers last season, especially in the first half, had a lot of success going to the air against the Chargers. They burnt the Chargers on a long touchdown pass last year up in Forest City.
Yeah, they really did. So a lot of big keys he talked about. Of course, Crest got some injuries they're dealing with, some guys beat up tonight, so we may see a variety of players. But ultimately, Andy, it's everybody playing as a team. That's what they're looking for tonight, to hopefully stay unbeaten and continue to play well. When we come back on our stadium pregame show sponsored by Cleveland Regional Medical Center, we may have some of that national anthem. We'll be getting closer to tonight's kickoff. We'll go on the field to Rob Rue. Great to have you along. We're getting you ready for Crest and East Rutherford, and we're coming back after this 3-minute break on KTCBroadcasting.com at 1390 AM WOHS.
This is Woody Durham for Tommy Hamrick Nationwide Insurance Agency in Shelby, where you get a team of experienced agents all working for the Nationwide team. And, of course, there's Tommy, a former Tar Heel athlete and UNC graduate. When it comes time for the insurance you need for your home, auto, business, and life, go see the winning team at Tommy Hamrick Nationwide Insurance Agency, your exclusive, on-your-side certified agency, located at the corner of Gidney and South DeKalb Streets in Shelby.
Now you can rent to own your new carport from B&B Buildings in Cherryville, Denver, and Shelby. Come in for all the details. And 5% down delivers, plus local financing is available on all units. And check out the selection of repos and factory price reductions. Old Hickory Buildings, new lofted barns, and now rent-to-own carports. At B&B Buildings, Highway 150 in Cherryville, Highway 74 East in Shelby, and Highway 16 in Denver. The new menu has arrived at Smoke on the Square in Uptown Shelby. Check out their new $5.99 lunch specials. Other great specials include their after 5 p.m. specials. Tuesday is senior night. Take 25% off. Wednesday is seafood night featuring peel and eat shrimp and crab legs. And Thursday is wing night. Wings just 35 cents when you dine in or 45 cents for carry out. And check out the Chef's Choice specials on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at Smoke on the Square, 5 East Marion Street in Uptown Shelby.
ENT Carolina is not your parents' allergy treatment. Now, no shots, no pain, no fear. Ask about the sublingual immunotherapy. Drops are placed under your tongue, and just 2 minutes a day is all it takes. It's safe, effective, and you do it on your own schedule. And best of all, no weekly doctor visits. Call today for a consultation with one of their board-certified allergy specialists. Visit a location near you. ENT Carolina, 2520 Aberdeen Road in Gastonia, 1212 Spruce Street in Belmont, and 1180 Wyke Road in Shelby.
Since 1986, Witherspoon Insurance Agency in Shelby has been serving families across Shelby and Cleveland County. And today, Wayne Witherspoon continues the tradition of bringing you the best insurance at the best possible price with names like The Hartford, Safeco, Progressive, National General Insurance, and Travelers. Drop by their office at 125 North Lafayette Street in Shelby and talk with one of their friendly hometown agents. Witherspoon Insurance Agency, your independent insurance agency since 1986.
Check out the new storage buildings at the Roundup Store in Shelby. Come see the new vinyl siding storage building and the new T111 wood siding buildings. The Roundup wooden storage buildings are built to last, and check out their line of beautiful kitchen cabinets too. Make your dream kitchen a reality. The Roundup Store, 1610 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby. Open 8:30 to 5:30 Monday through Friday, 8:30 till noon on Saturday. Online at RoundupStoreShelby.com.
In the Crest High School ROTC. And Andy momentarily will have our national anthem as we're getting you ready for Crest and East Rutherford tonight on KTCBroadcasting.com at 1390 AM WOHS. Great to have you along tonight. We'll momentarily be going down to Rob Roop as well after our national anthem as we head back on the field. National anthem from the Crest High School chorus here at Sid Bryson Stadium as we get ready for the kickoff, the Chargers and the Cavaliers. And let's head down to Rob Roop on that Crest sideline. And Rob, let's talk keys to the game tonight. And obviously, Rob, offensively, you mentioned a little bit earlier, good balance for the Chargers. That's going to be very, very important tonight. Some nice drives and continue to do what you're doing, as you mentioned, in the trenches as well.
And I tell you what, Tim, one thing that I think we need to take, you know, pay attention to emotion tonight. We mentioned it is senior night. The routine's a little different tonight as you had the players recognize before the game. So let's see how the Chargers respond emotion-wise in the tonight. And when you take a look at the starting lineup, a little different tonight for the Chargers as well. So let's see how the Chargers come out.
Well, let's take a look.